In our today's video, we are going to discuss about subnetting on class P IP address. As here you can see guys, from the IP address 172.168.10.0 with the CIDR value 22, we will learn how to find this subnet mask, how to find the total number of network can be created, how to find the total number of host on each network, how to find the network ID and the broadcast ID of all the networks. At the end of this video, I will also take a test with you guys so that whether you understand the concept or not, it will be clear. Before starting this video, I would like to tell you guys, this video is on user demand. One of my viewers has requested me to make a video on how to do subnetting on class B IP address. So here it is. If you have any question, if you have any doubt, or if you want me to make a video on any topic, please let me know in the comment section below. I will try to upload as soon as possible. Hello friends, this is Abhishek here and welcome back to my channel Technical Tech. Let's the tech begin. So guys, the IP address is 172.168.10.0 and the CIDR value is 22. Hence the IP address starts from 172. It indicates it is a class B IP address, and by default the subnet mask of class B IP address is 255.255.0.0. This is because by default 16 bits are reserved for the network and the remaining 16 bits are reserved for the host. So once you count the binary bits in the network part, the total amount you will get is 255. That is why the subnet mask of class B IP address is 255.255.0.0. Guys, the CIDR value indicates the total number of network bits. Okay, so as here you can see in this example, the CIDR value is 22, but by default only 16 bits are reserved for the network. So how do we get another 6 bits? Right, that 6 bit we have to borrow from the host to make it 22. So after borrowing the 6 bit from the host, the new subnet mask what you will get is 255.255.252.0. Now the question is, from where do we get this number 252? It is the value of binary bits which you have borrowed from the host. As here you can see, the value of last octet is 2 to the power 7 plus the value of the 7th octet is 2 to the power 6 plus the value of the 6th octet is 2 to the power 5 plus the value of the 5th octet is 2 to the power 4 plus the value of the 4th octet is 2 to the power 3 plus the value of the 3rd octet is 2 to the power 2. So once you calculate all this number, the total amount what you will get is 252. Is it clear guys? Now let's find out how to find the number of network. The formula for this is 2 to the power n. Here n indicates the total number of bits borrowed from the host. So how many bits we have borrowed from the host? Yes, we have borrowed 6 bits. So what will be our number of network? It will be 2 to the power 6, which is equal to 64. Means you can create total number of 64 network from this address. Now let's find out how to find the number of IP address on each network. The formula is very simple. Again, we have to use 2 to the power n. But in this time, n indicates the total number of remaining bits in the host part. So hence we have borrowed 6 bits from the host. So how many bits are remaining? That is 8 plus 2, which is equal to 10. So we are going to write here 2 to the power 10, which is equal to 1024. It means on each network you will get 1024 IP address, right? Okay, now let's find out how to find the number of host on each network. Guys, number of IP address and number of host are two different things. Number of IP address means total number of IP address what you will get in the network. And number of host means the total number of IP address you can assign to the users in each network. Okay, so formula for this is 2 to the power n minus 2. Here n indicates the total number of remaining bits on the host. Okay, so how many bits are remaining in the host? That is 10. So we are going to write here 2 to the power 10 minus 2, which is equal to 1022. It means you have 1022 host IP address on each network. Now the question is, why we have subtract 2 here, right? This is because on every network, the first IP address is reserved for the network ID and the last IP address is reserved for the broadcast ID, and these two IP addresses you cannot assign to the clients in a network. So for this reason, we have to subtract 2 on each network. So from the answer, what we have found is total number of network is 64 and total number of host on each network is 1022. Now it's time to find the network ID. So how to find the network ID of each network? See guys, if the number of host is in a small size like 2, 4, 10, 16, 20, it will be very easy for you to find the network ID. But in this scenario, the total number of host is 1022. So if you count 1022 IP address on each network, it will be very difficult for you to find the network ID, right? But I am going to show you the best and the easiest method to find the network ID of all the network. So to find the network ID, what you have to do is just find the value of last octet which you have borrowed from the host. So we have borrowed 6 octet from the host, right? So what is the value of last octet what we have borrowed? It is 2 to the power 2. So what will be our answer? It is equal to 4. Now you can easily find the network ID of all the networks available. Just you have to keep adding 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 and that's it. Let me show you how it works. As we know that the first network ID will be 172.168.0.0, right? Now what will be your second network ID? Just you have to add 4. So the second network ID will be 172.168.4.0. Now what will be our third network ID? It will be 172.168.8.0. Now what will be our fourth network ID? Yes, just add 8 plus 4, which is equal to 12. So the fourth network ID will be 172.168.12.0. What will be the fifth network ID? Yes, just add 12 plus 4, which is equal to 16. So the fifth network ID will be 172.168.16.0. So this is how you can find the network ID. You have to keep adding 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 until you find the last network ID. So what will be our last network ID? So the network ID of the 64th network is 172.168.252.1. Why it is last network ID? If you again add 4, so it will become 256, which means the network ID will become 172.169. So we don't want to do this, right? So that's why this is your last network ID. Now how to find the broadcast ID? It is very simple guys. Just you have to subtract 1 from the next network ID. As for example, as here you can see, the network ID of second network is 172.168.4.0. So if you subtract 1, what you will get? You will get 172.168.3.255. Now what will be the broadcast ID of second network? Same, you have to subtract 1 from its next network ID. So the network ID of third network is 172.168.8.0, right? So just subtract 1 from this. So what you will get? You will get 172.168.7.255. Now here is a small test for you guys. I will give you 10 seconds, okay? Just tell me the correct answer in the comment section below. The question is, what will be the broadcast ID of the third network? Yes, the broadcast ID of the third network will be 172.168.11.255. So this is how you can find the broadcast ID. Just imagine if someone asks you the IP address 172.168.10.0, it falls under which network? So what will be your answer? The answer is very simple. This IP address is falls under the third network, which network ID is 172.168.8.0. Okay? Because the IP address 172.168.10.0 falls before the fourth network, so it falls under the third network, right? Now it's time for the surprise test. Before starting the surprise test, I would like to tell you guys, you can visit our website www.learnavi.com, and also you can download our Android application Networking Plus, where you can easily practice the networking quiz. In the application, you will also find basic interview questions. You can also participate in a quiz, and you can also find the various questions which is related to subnetting, which is related to computer networking. So it will be very easy for you to take participate in your real exam, because all the questions are designed as it is asked in a real exam. So guys, the app is available in Google Play Store, and also the link is given in the description section below. So please visit my website and download the app. So today's question is, from the IP address 172.168.10.0 with the CIDR value 28, find the subnet mask, find the total number of network can be created, find the total number of host on each network, find the network ID and the broadcast ID of first, second, third and the last network. Let's see whether you are able to pass the test or not. Please guys, write the answer in the comment section below, then only it will be confirmed for me whether you have understand the concept or not. If you want to talk to me live, you can like my Facebook page, link is given in the description section below. Every Sunday at night 8 PM I used to come live into my Facebook page. And with that, please guys, do subscribe to my channel Technical Tech, and also press the bell icon so that whenever I update a new video, you will get a notification. Thanks for watching.